This is a 2000 model year Lexus RX300. This has the V6 3.0-liter 1MZ-FE. This car is being prepared to replace the engine. On this car, the best way to replace the engine is to drop the entire engine and transmission assembly on the engine cradle down under the car. The engine cradle is held to the frame by four bolts. There are two on the front and two on the rear. Let's go through all that we did in order to get ready to drop this engine and transmission. First, we've removed the windshield wiper assemblies and the windshield wiper tray. Then we've gone through from the glove box area and disconnected the harness from the ECU and pulled it out. Disconnected the power steering fluid reservoir from the frame, pulled it up to the side. We have removed the alternator. We have removed the side mount or torque mount from the side of the engine. Over on this side, we've removed the battery, we've removed the airbox, we've disconnected the fuel line. Comes right back here. We've disconnected the heater hoses. We've removed the upper radiator hose and the lower both radiator hoses. We've removed both radiator hoses. We've disconnected the transmission shift cable from the transmission, pulled it back here. These are the harness connectors that go inside the fuse box, and we've opened up the fuse box and disconnected these two connectors from underneath, set them back aside. We've disconnected the evap line that goes to the evap hard line right here. And all in all, on the top side, we've also disconnected the AC lines from the compressor. We're going to leave the compressor right where it is. And on the top side, there's nothing left that connects the engine to the frame. And same on the bottom side. Let's look through that. When I look up from under the car on all four sides, which is rear, and under the front, and on the driver's side, and on the passenger side, there is nothing left that connects the engine and transmission assembly or the cradle to the chassis. The only thing that is still in place is the steering column U-joint. It is just sitting gently on top of the steering rack pinion, and it will come free when the engine assembly is lowered. So what I've done here is I've set these jack stands at locations that match the engine cradle, and I'm just going to lower the car onto the jack stand. Here we're looking from underneath. Everything is supported. Got the two on the passenger side and the two on the driver's side. Now I go under the car and I start loosening up the bolts that hold the cradle to the frame. all the corners have been unfastened, so in theory I should be able to lift up the car and the engine and transmission will stay on the jack stands. And let's do a quick walk around. Everything else looks just fine. I put this added jack stand here for safety, just in case the frame, the cradle were to rock backwards, but it did not come into play. So all in all, pretty successful. I hope that you enjoyed this video on how to remove the engine from a Lexus RX300. Thank you very much for watching.